Hey everyone, I'm outside GMC and actually ward number 150, which is the examination hall. Both my parents are tested positive, and that too it's a pneumonia COVID that they have. It's been 3-4 days that my parents have been here, and my dad's health has been deteriorating very badly every day. Like the oxygen levels were dropping down. Just want to tell the government is to please have proper oximeters for the doctors and have the thinning injections in stock. Trust me, because yesterday 1:30 in the night my dad was struggling. He was almost like his oxygen level was dropping down to 55, and we were trying our best to make sure that, you know, it comes back. So, and it's been fluctuating day in and day out. Both my parents are in the hospital. One is in ward 50 and now my dad's taken to ICU. If the doctors are given good equipment, trust me, none of their oximeters were working yesterday. The ones that have been come in stock also are not working. The doctors have been asking all patients for their oximeters and checking other patients. And when I asked the doctor, like, you know, why are you not having proper oximeters? Like, we got stock, but they are all damaged. What the heck, yeah? What the heck is happening? Oximeters is something which keeps everything into control, yet it's like, you know, there's damaged oximeters are coming. Damaged oximeters, what the heck? Plus thinning of the blood, injections are not in stock. I mean, they are in stock in the pharmacy, but they are not in stock over here at ward number 150. 1:30 in the morning, I had to rush, get injections and bring it over here.
I mean, if
my parents are suffering, I can understand how many parents are suffering all over Goa. It's hard when the doctor in the ICU tells you that my dad has severe pneumonia on either of the lungs. And I can't do anything much right now. Just pray to God that he gets all right and he comes out of it. Every day we've been fighting and voicing. This bloody government has kept everything open for everyone to come inside. They've not been strict.
Trust me, also.
So many families are dying every day. Even in this ward 150, we've seen someone die. There are no barricades. Like, you know, we are seeing everyone suffer. We're trying to support each other. Some people are not even taking the people back home, especially those who are in rental because they've got COVID. They are left to live on the street. There was this one mother over here who was bitterly crying yesterday, and we are all trying to console each other. Today, this is the state what's happening in Goa, where people are homeless also, where people, medication is not in stock, and oximeters, which is the most important thing, are not being given to the doctors so that they can check and take necessary alternative precautions, saying, okay, fine, he has to go here, he has to go somewhere else.
I don't know
what is happening with this government of ours. I mean, what decisions have they taken? Small, small things which are so important are being neglected. I'm telling you, this is what I witnessed in ward 150 here. Doctors don't have oximeters. Doctors don't have basic oximeters. They're all damaged or not replaced. Just requesting everyone around the world, please pray for Goa and for all the Goans. Because this is very bad. It's a very bad scene here. Very, very bad scene. I mean, I've never cried as much as I've kept myself strong. I can't anymore. Because my dad's in ICU, my mom's in 150. And I'm trying my best. Please pray for everyone, just not my parents, please pray for everyone that we come out of this. We come out of this, guys. And that's why I'm letting you all know that this government, please share it to the Vishwajit Rane and to the CM. Bastards, they are bastards. Today my parents are suffering because of that. I've never got COVID home. I've not been tested positive. I've never got, though I've been out working. But my parents were in Vasco for some work and then they came back with that COVID. God help all of us. And please take care of your loved dear ones. And also to let you all know that my parents' test took 5 days to come at the Taligao COVID center. 5 days. 5 days and we still didn't go and collect it. When we did the report, when we did the test, I said come and collect it after 2 days. Nothing. I came with the reference number, I came to GMC, we could not trace it. My father directly, a man, if you all know my dad, the man who could walk so well, is totally today bedridden. Totally. I can get the oxygen mask off. I've never seen my dad suffering like that. And today I'm sharing it with you all because it's not only me, but so many other families have been suffering. So many people that we've interacted with have lost their mothers, their fathers, because of negligence of the government and sometimes the whole system that was not put in place. So please provide oximeters and the thinning injections for all the patients. COVID medicines have to be free. Damn it, it has to be free. It's a freaking pandemic. You're like getting the funds. Give free medication to the people. Give free medication. I can afford, but a lot of other people can't afford. It's hard to see people all around suffering, crying, and all their stories. God be with Goa. God be with all the Goans, and all to all the Goans. Very important. If you have a slight cold, fever, headache, anything, please do a CT scan. Don't wait and don't take it lightly. Take a CT scan so that you know where are you placed. Please. It is the need of the hour that we, you know, fight this battle together. And whatever I can bring to light, I will bring to light. I will highlight. I'm heading down to see my mother. I've already told her that dad's taken to ICU and we should not worry. But inside my heart, the doctors told me, like, you know, dad's, both the lungs are severely damaged. And it breaks to see my heart, my dad, like, suffer like this. Never seen him suffer. I've never seen him suffer. It's been 3 nights of in the hospital, which I've been on and off. It's not only me, but a lot of people have been suffering, guys. Take care, Goa. And to everyone who's also suffering along with me, be strong and let's try and fight this out. Lots of good people have left. Even another friend, Julio, yesterday passed away. Good people are dying because of this infection. God help all of us.